Hello, check. All right, people, I believe we are live. Welcome to Catalysis by Vedantu. My name is Pahul. And if I'm audible and visible, please write here in the chat box. You know the drill, yeah? And if you're new to the channel, then this is the drill. Fine. So, people, we are here to discuss the very first class of surface chemistry. Now, this chapter is a mixture between physical chemistry and inorganic chemistry. What I mean to say is this chapter has a lot of facts. Very less calculation, and the questions that will come from this chapter in your JEE NEET examinations will be more theory centric and not that practice centric. Okay, so what I mean to say is there won't be a lot of calculations involved in the questions of this chapter, although you can make questions which involve calculation. Most of the questions that come from this chapter will be more theoretical in nature, okay, more memory based in nature. So you need to understand the concepts really well. This being the last chapter that we have for physical chemistry of your 12th class syllabus. After this, our syllabus will be over and then we will start our sprint type question solving classes very soon. Okay. So, surface chemistry, very easy chapter. Today's class is going to be exceptionally easy and this is going to be like an interaction class. Okay. Like almost all first classes, this one's going to be even better. Gappe marenge aaj hum, we're just going to talk to each other. All right. So, let's make sure that the chat box is nice and buzzing. So people, today we are going to discuss about the very basic ideas behind adsorption. Okay, the mathematics of adsorption, we'll start from tomorrow. So what is adsorption? Yeah, adsorption to the untrained ear sounds like a grammatical error. Okay. Adsorption. Because we all know what is absorption, isn't it? Ye to sabko pata hi rehta hai. So the first time when I heard the word adsorption, I was very small. I was what, maybe 10 years old, okay? And everyone knows what is absorption. So when I heard the word adsorption, I started laughing. Okay, I started laughing. It's not adsorption, it is absorption. And then I got to realize that this is a different thing altogether. All right, yeah. And Anand, can you please open your ears? If you think I'm speaking in some other language, then please. Okay. Yeah, Ashwath, thank you so much for helping me. Okay, anyway, so adsorption versus absorption. Now we all know what absorption is. We've all seen what absorption is, and the very interesting example that we all know is of a sponge. Yes. What does a sponge do? The sponge basically captures all the water inside it. Yeah, water is now spread through and through the sponge. Whenever we are washing a car or whenever we are washing the dishes, yeah, or let's say you throw your pillow into water, what will happen? Yeah, when you put your clothes in water, when you put your towel inside water, the water is absorbed by the entire material, isn't it? So absorption happens throughout. Yeah, absorption happens throughout. So there is no doubt to what absorption is. But on the other hand, adsorption is something that happens only on the surface. It's a surface phenomenon. Okay, that is why we read it in the chapter of surface chemistry. Adsorption is something that happens on the surface. Can you guys give me some examples of adsorption? See, the best way to understand anything is by taking lots of examples. Can you guys tell me about the examples of adsorption? Have you ever seen adsorption happen? If yes, then what are the specific examples that you can give me? Okay. People who are asking about metallurgy, don't worry. Saurav sir will be taking metallurgy very soon. Okay, Saurav sir is covering up the inorganic chemistry portion of our channel. Very soon metallurgy will be done by Saurav sir. If you want a very quick revision on metallurgy, the class is already there. Just write metallurgy Pahul sir on YouTube, you'll get it. Fine. Okay. Alright, so Ashwathanand is saying particles get stuck to the surface and not enter the bulk of the medium. Okay, that is fine, but what is the example? Ashwath, yeah, well, you can think about it like that. Chromatography, okay, Vidya, to a decent extent, you can say, definitely. Silica gel, very interesting. Purna is giving an example that almost all of us have seen somewhere. Have you guys seen silica gel? Those silica gel packets
Have you seen that?
Okay, charcoal, chalk powder on duster. Chalk powder on duster, okay, you can say that it's adsorption. Bilkul, definitely. Dust sticking to the surface, okay, that can also be thought of like that, okay. So everyone who's here, let me remind you that I teach in English primarily. One or two sentences I might use of Hindi. If you want to learn primarily in Hindi, agar aap bilkul Hindi mein classes chahte ho, so Vedantu JEE channel pe ja sakte ho, Vedantu NEET channel pe ja sakte ho. Wahan pe hamare jitne bhi teachers hain, Abhinav sir ho gaye, Harsh sir ho gaye, Love sir ho gaye, Arvind Arora sir ho gaye, sab Hindi mein padhate hain. So since if everyone teaches in Hindi, what's the point, right? So if you want to learn in Hindi, you can go there. Over here, things are going to be primarily in English. Alrighty, fine. So Vijay is saying silica gel absorbs water vapor. Silica gel doesn't absorb water vapor. Okay. Chalk dipped in ink. Okay, that's an interesting example that we'll see. So the most common example of adsorption. Okay. The most common, the most simple example of adsorption, which I don't think anyone told me, is chalk on blackboard. My dear friends, as I told you, adsorption is a surface phenomena, and we'll read its formal definition very soon. But when you write with chalk on board, forget about chalk on board, yaar. Let's think about pencil on paper. What happens there? What happens when you write with pencil on paper? Does the entire paper now have graphite in it? No. Basically, the graphite brushes off from your pencil. Yeah, and it now sticks to the surface of the paper. Yeah, what is happening over here? Your graphite sticks to the surface of paper. This is called adsorption. Over here, the chalk will stick to the surface of the blackboard, isn't it? So this sticking to the surface, this particular thing, formally is known as adsorption. Alright? Fine. Let me show you what that silica gel thing is. A lot of people have misconceptions about silica gel. Let me show you what it looks like. And when I show you the images, you'll understand, this is what you're talking about. Here you go. Can you see these images? Silica gel desiccant, throw away, do not eat. Yeah? These packets. This is what it looks like from the inside. Okay. This is what it looks like from the inside. So these silica gel packets come in a lot of things. They sometimes come in medicine bottles. They sometimes comes when you purchase new shoes. Yes. They sometimes come in electronic items where they don't want moisture to get in. So what are these silica gel particles? These tiny, tiny particles of silica gel. Okay. They adsorb water. They don't absorb water, they just adsorb water. Water molecules, the moisture molecules, just go and sit on the surface of these beads. Okay, so if this is the bead of silica gel, if this is the bead of that silica gel, yeah, then what's going to happen is the water molecules will just sit on the surface. The water molecules will just sit on the surface. Now my question to all of you is, okay, my question to all of you is, why am I using these small, small beads? Yeah. Why am I using so many tiny, 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 tiny beads of silica? Why am I using so many particles of silica gel? Why can't I simply use a big box of silica gel? Batao. Huh? Let's say the total volume of these spheres combined is as good as the volume of this box. Let's say that all of these tiny beads combined are 100 grams and this entire box is also 100 grams. Both are silica gel. Why do I want to use these tiny, tiny particles and why not the entire box? Tell me. And as Tanmay is telling me, as Anirudh is telling me, as Sriswat is telling me, as lots of people are telling me, yes. That is so that our surface area increases. It's a surface phenomena, yes. More surface phenomena. That's pretty obvious, I believe. So over here, the entire surface area will not be enough to capture a lot of water. But when you break it apart, you are creating lots of surface area. Yeah, you're creating lots of surface area. So over here, a lot more water molecules can get absorbed. So in case you want to promote any surface phenomena, all right, in case you want to promote any surface phenomenon, all you need to do is increase the surface area. And how do you increase the surface area? You divide things finely into small particles. Surface phenomena, adsorption is one example. Catalysis, not the channel by the way, the actual process of catalysis, catalyst, working of a catalyst, that is also a surface phenomena. So do you remember when you studied organic chemistry, especially in the process of hydrogenation of alkenes? It says finely divided nickel, finely divided platinum. Have you seen that sentence? Yeah. When you study about Rane nickel, they'll tell you that it's finely divided nickel. I'm pretty sure you've seen that word finely divided written next to the catalyst. Catalysis is a surface phenomena. It is very similar to adsorption. Okay. When catalysts act on a reaction, it is a surface phenomena. On the surface, the reaction happens faster. So to increase the surface area, you finally divide the catalyst a lot. Yeah, that's the idea behind dividing a catalyst, because the reaction will happen faster on the surface of that catalyst. Fine. So that's the idea behind the surface area. So let's now look at the formal definition of adsorption. The accumulation of molecular species at the surface rather than in the bulk of a solid or liquid is termed as adsorption. Why does this happen? Let's try to understand that as well. What is it? What are the examples? We know. How do we increase the efficiency of it? We know. This is the definition. You can read it. It's pretty obvious. Now let us try to understand, why does it happen? What's the reason behind adsorption? So think about this particular block. There's some solid block. All right. Now there are lots of molecules inside the solid block, very closely packed with each other. If we look at a molecule inside, okay, if we look at a molecule inside, this particular molecule is facing forces from all directions, isn't it? This particular molecule is facing forces from all directions. This molecule can be called the bulk molecule. What do you mean by bulk? Bulk means when there are a lot of things. Yeah. Wholesale bolte hai na, jisko apan hindi, matlab, thok mein lana kehte hai, jisko hindi mein. Yeah. When we say wholesale, what does wholesale mean? Wholesale means you are getting something in bulk. Bulk means a collection of a lot of things. So whenever you are inside a solid or a liquid, you call it the bulk of the solid or liquid. Okay. Whenever you are inside a solid or liquid, you are in the bulk of the solid or liquid. Okay, so when you're swimming on the surface, you're not in the bulk of the liquid. When you are sea diving, okay, when you're diving under the sea, then you're in the bulk of the liquid. Fine. So when you're looking at the molecule in the bulk, it is facing forces from all directions. Also, do you realize if you have a bulk molecule, it'll be attracting other molecules from all directions? Yeah. Yahan se bhi attract karega, it'll attract from here as well, it's going to attract from here as well, it's going to attract from here as well, it's going to attract from here as well. So it is trying to pull other molecules towards itself, isn't it? Very obvious. That's why the solid is a solid, that's why liquid is a liquid, because all the molecules are attracting each other very well. Yeah. But now let us focus our attention onto a molecule that resides on the surface. This poor little guy, it can attract only things that are inside the bulk. Outside the bulk, it is very lonely. Yeah, can you see that sad face? Very, very sad. Yeah. So when it's sitting on the surface, andar to bahut kuch mil raha hai isko, bahar it's like. So when any other molecule comes close to it, let's take this green colored molecule now. Let's remove the sad face. So let's say some other molecule is coming close to it. Yeah, this can be a molecule of chalk. This can be a molecule of that graphite, of pencils graphite. Yeah. So when this molecule comes closer, the black guy is like, hey. So this is going to start attracting this one as well. Just to balance forces. Why does adsorption happen? Adsorption happens in order to balance the forces inside the bulk and outside the surface. Okay? Forces initially are not balanced. Okay? Forces initially are not balanced with each other. Bulk forces are not equal to the forces outside the surface. So whenever something comes in contact with the surface, life becomes good for the surface molecule, and now the forces can be balanced. Fine. So it happens because of these forces that are not balanced in the bulk versus the surface. Okay. So now let us think about the thermodynamics or the energetics of adsorption. Can anyone tell me what will be the enthalpy change of adsorption? What will be the delta H? Will heat be released in this process, or will heat be absorbed in this process? What do you think? Soch ke dekho. Two things are attracting each other. They're coming closer to each other. And then, of course, energy will be released, isn't it? Yeah. Two things attracting each other, coming closer to each other, becoming more stable. So, of course, energy will be released. So, for adsorption, all the time, adsorption is an exothermic process. Yeah. Energy of the system is reducing. Two things, when they come closer, they become very happy. So it is an exothermic process. Delta H is less than zero. If you don't know what exothermic and delta H less than zero is, then please rethink your choices of life. Go and join commerce rather than studying chemistry, because this is something that we learn in 11th class thermodynamics and chemistry, and in thermodynamics and physics as well. So enthalpy change of adsorption is always exothermic. Now let us think of the entropy change. My dear friends, entropy is basically the freedom of a system, the degree of randomness of a system. Let us imagine that this particular molecule is gaseous and this particular dabba is solid. Is there anything happening to the mobility of the solid molecule? No. To think about entropy, you can think about mobility. Yeah. If I have lots of space, I will move around randomly. Main idhar ghumega mast ekdam. Yeah, but in front of you, I don't have a lot of space. In my house, there's a lot of space. I can roam around anywhere. But if I have to stick inside the frame of the camera, this is all the movement that I can do. Yeah, maybe I can do this as well, but that's just pointless. Yeah. So the thing is, more space, more randomness. Less space, less randomness. Yeah. Now, am I changing the mobility of the solid? No. Solid had this much space, solid has that much space. Solid's mobility is not changing. But think about the gas. Do you agree that the mobility of the gas decreases? Mobility of gas decreases. Isn't it? Yeah. Gas earlier was able to move freely in the entire atmosphere, and now the solid has captured it by the bat. You just sit with me. Yeah. So the gas is not as random anymore. Yeah. When the mobility decreases, mobility matlab, the freedom of movement, when it decreases, this becomes less random. So if your randomness is decreasing, my dear friends, entropy change of this process because of the gas. For solid, entropy is not changing. The gas, because it becomes limited in its mobility, it's not able to move around. Therefore, the entropy change in this process, delta S, is also less than zero. Entropy change, and this is only for the system. I'm not talking about the universe. Okay, let's not even worry about the universe. For a process to be spontaneous, delta S of the universe has to be greater than zero. We're just talking about the entropy of the system. And for the system, because the gas is now less mobile, the gas is not able to move anymore, your entropy change for the system is less than zero. Theek hai? Anirudh, so the thing is that the silica gel does not absorb water at all. It only adsorbs water. So even if you have a big volume, it's not going to take water inside it. Okay. Absorption and adsorption happen at the same time very rarely. Most of the times, it's just either of the process that happens. Okay. Udit, I'll take your doubt later, man. Yeah, you can remove water when it's vicinal as well. That's not a problem. Ether bana de bhai. Think about it. Take a vicinal dial, make an ether out of it. Theoretically, that's possible. Chalo, anyway, Udit's doubt was a little unrelated, but anyway. So, ye ho gaya aapka adsorption. Delta H is less than 0, delta S is less than 0. My dear friends, what is the criteria for spontaneity? Delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S, isn't it? Now you know that this particular thing is also negative. So this entire thing becomes positive. Do you realize delta H has to be negative for this process to be spontaneous? A process is spontaneous when the Gibbs energy change of the system is less than 0. Yeah, this value has to be negative for a process to be spontaneous. Now we've realized that T delta S is a positive value. So delta H has to be negative, isn't it? So in the beginning of the adsorption, there is a lot of heat that is released. Then when the adsorption keeps happening, the delta H keeps on reducing. Yeah, the value of heat released keeps on reducing. So initially, when you start the adsorption, it will release 100 joules of heat. Then 2 minutes later, it will be releasing only 10 joules of heat. Then 5 minutes later, once the adsorption is done, once the equilibrium has reached, it will not release any more heat. This process will become at equilibrium. Yeah, delta G is equal to zero at equilibrium. I hope you understand. So when the value of delta H in the negative sign becomes equal to the value of T delta S in the positive sign, equilibrium is achieved. Do you understand? So initially, lots of heat is released. Slowly, the heat release reduces, and then it reaches a point where it is at equilibrium. Okay? As simple as that. So this is behind the adsorption's definition. Why does it happen? What are the thermodynamics of it, and how do the thermodynamics happen with respect to time? Initially, lots of energy is released, keeps on reducing until its value is equal to the positive value of T delta S. Done. Okay, then you reach equilibrium. Whatever I have taught you till now, I guarantee you, if a question comes from this chapter, that theory will help you solve that question. I know it looks like we have just had a conversation for 25 minutes, isn't it? Aisa lagta gappe maari hain bas. But trust me, whatever I've taught you in the last 20 minutes, direct questions come from these basic ideas. In JEE Mains, NEET, and sometimes in JEE Advanced as well. Okay, so this is very important. Enthalpy change, entropy change of adsorption, this idea is very, very important. Okay. So now, my dear friends, let's think about this process of adsorption as something that has reached the equilibrium. Okay, let's think about the process of adsorption as something that has reached the equilibrium. So let me remove this now. Okay, let's think of it as an equilibrium. So what we are doing over here is, let's assume that the adsorption is happening on a solid. So solid plus gas is in equilibrium with this solid gas system. The solid surface has a lot of gas on it, and the delta H for this process is less than zero. So let's think about this process as an equilibrium process, and it is an exothermic process. Now you have to tell me temperature increase or temperature decrease, which thing favors this process? Does increasing the temperature favor the process, or decreasing the temperature favor the process? This is the hint. Think about it as an equilibrium exothermic reaction. Hint is there in the Le Chatelier's principle. Exothermic process. How do I make it happen? Should I increase the temperature? Should I decrease the temperature? This is also a hint. This mathematics is also a hint. Yeah. So isn't it obvious that when you decrease the temperature, it favors adsorption? Yes. Because it is an exothermic process, when you decrease the temperature, is going to favor the adsorption. All right. If you don't understand how or why, this is something that we discuss in the Le Chatelier's principle in chemical equilibrium chapter. Yeah, exothermic processes are favored to go towards the products when you decrease temperatures. Okay, chalo, done, awesome. Now, this is about the basic idea behind the energetics, the mathematics of adsorption. Okay, but is life so simple? Are we done with adsorption? Not really. There are actually two kinds of adsorption. Okay, there are actually two kinds of adsorption, and we will understand things about those two different kinds right now, and then we'll see what are the properties of these two different kinds. One adsorption, which is very simple, is known as physisorption, also known as physical adsorption. Physisorption. The other one, which is a little more entertaining, is chemisorption. Alright. And before I get into physisorption versus chemisorption, my dear friends, can you tell me the difference between van der Waals forces and a chemical bond? What is the difference between these two? This is something that you would have studied in the States of Matter chapter, NCRT, class 11th. Or you've studied it in chemical bonding, somewhere or the other, this has been taught to you in 11th class. What's the difference between van der Waals forces and a proper chemical bond? And Purna is saying the difference is only there in the force of attraction. Do other people agree with Purna? Ali is saying van der Waals forces are weak forces. Sorry. Anyone else? Yeah, chemical bond is stronger. Okay, Ali. Srishwad is saying van der Waals force can be thought of as a type of a weak chemical bond. Okay. Aman, we'll go there. We'll go there. You are on the right track. First is weak, the other is very strong in comparison. Absolutely. Very good job, people. Awesome. Harini, is it so? I don't know why. Maybe the lighting, I don't know. So people, that's the thing. Van der Waals forces are basically weak attractive forces. Van der Waals forces and chemical bond, both are attractive forces. Okay, both are pretty much attractive forces. Van der Waals forces are weak attractive forces. Yeah, these are weak attractive forces. So whenever you have gases. Of gases, maybe, are the molecules infinitely far from each other? In reality, no. Yeah, when you move your hand around, you can feel the air hitting your hand, because there are a bunch of molecules in this particular space. Yeah, those molecules are keeping each other close using van der Waals forces. Now the forces are weak, that's why it's a gas. Okay, if the forces were stronger, it would attract much more. Yeah, and one more reason, why does acetone evaporate but water does not evaporate? Because acetone primarily has these dipole-dipole interactions, which are comparable to van der Waals interactions. Not exactly the same, but think about a liquid which evaporates versus water. Water has hydrogen bonds, which are a little stronger, but let's say petrol. Petrol is a very good example. Petrol has van der Waals forces of interaction in it. So petrol evaporates very quickly. Yeah, petrol, if you throw on the surface, if you throw petrol anywhere, it'll just evaporate in 1 minute. Yeah, but if you throw water anywhere, it'll evaporate after, let's say, 1 hour. So the thing is, water's forces of attraction are stronger, petrol's forces of attraction are weaker. In petrol, we call those forces van der Waals interactions. In water, we call those forces hydrogen bonding interactions. So simply, van der Waals forces are these weak forces of attraction. Chemical bond is a very strong force of interaction. Yeah, very strong force of attraction. Isko nikalne ke liye, you need to do a lot of effort. So the basic difference between physisorption and chemisorption is this. Physisorption happens by the virtue of van der Waals forces.
Okay. So, what do I mean by that? Whenever we've got a solid and we've got a gaseous molecule, over here, the forces of attraction between them will be van der Waals forces. Okay, so this is your solid, this is the surface, and this is the gaseous molecule. And this is your surface. Cool? So the surface interactions between the solid and gas, when they are van der Waals interactions, it is called Fizeau's option. Very simple, chilled out adsorption. Okay, not very strong. You can just rub on the surface of the solid, the gas will come out. Let's think about Kemi's option on the other hand. That's why we call it Kemi's option, because it is based on a chemical bond. Okay, the solid and the gaseous molecule actually react with each other. There is a chemical bond that gets formed between these two. There's a chemical bond that gets formed between these two. Now you tell me, is it so easy to break a chemical bond? Can you take a crystal of salt and break it in half? No. One crystal of salt, okay, you can break it into smaller crystals, but if you reach one molecule of NaCl, can you break it? No. Yeah, can I simply just break apart this bottle entirely? No, because there are lots of metallic bonds over there. So the thing is, chemical bond breaking is very difficult. Kemi's option is the strong form of adsorption, right? So I can say that since this is a very chilled out form, this is a very chilled out form of adsorption, I can say that this happens easily, breaks apart easily. Okay, happens easily and breaks off easily. Fine. On the other hand, this guy, it is tough. Okay, so it needs more energy to happen. Okay, it needs lot more energy to happen. Okay, and it is very hard, sometimes impossible. Okay, sometimes it is impossible, but most of the time it's very hard to break. Okay, impossible bolo to, sometimes when you break it apart, then you will have some solid getting attached to the surface of the gaseous molecule. Okay, so it's very hard to reverse this process. Happens easily, breaks off easily, needs more energy. Okay, so this is like a formal marriage, this is like Tinder, if you guys relate to that example. Fine, got it. So this is the difference between Fizeau's option and Kemi's option. Okay, so my dear friends, since this Kemi's option is basically a chemical reaction, it needs more energy to happen. We've all studied this idea earlier in chemical kinetics. We've all studied this idea in chemical kinetics. My dear friends, this particular process over here, Kemi's option, this process needs activation energy. Okay, this particular process needs activation energy. Okay, because it's a chemical reaction. So what did I say on the last page? On the last page I said that low temperatures favor adsorption. Not always, because to start Kemi's option you need energy. To start Kemi's option you will need a high temperature. Once it starts, once it happens, then that high temperature is not required anymore. For Fizeau's option, you can keep on reducing the temperature, its extent will keep on increasing, because it's an easy process. It does not need that activation energy. You don't need to start it. But for this, you need to start it. Okay? Theek hai? And people who are asking these extracurricular doubts, you can just Google. Okay? Surya, just go to google.com. Fine? Mandar Joshi, I take classes only on YouTube. Okay.
See, so they're saying, does the external molecule always have to be gaseous? No, it can be solid or liquid as well. It's just easy to think about a gas. Okay. Ali is saying, is adsorption spontaneous? Yes, I showed you in the previous page, delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. It can be made spontaneous. Most of the adsorptions are spontaneous. That's why they happen. Okay. Cool. So, this guy needs more energy to happen. So, initially you need to provide at high temperature. Once the kinetics of the reaction are done, once the reaction happens, once it reaches equilibrium, then you can reduce the temperature. Okay. So, this needs activation energy. Initially, Chemi's option needs a high temperature. Fizi's option, from the beginning, you can do it at lower temperatures, because lower temperatures favor the equilibrium. Yeah. Activation energy is a kinetic term. Activation energy is something that you need to activate the reaction. Equilibrium has not been achieved yet. Once the equilibrium is achieved, then you can reduce the temperature to make sure there is more product. Fine. So initially, in Chemi's option, you need a higher temperature to activate the process. So these are the differences between Fizi's option and Chemi's option. These are mentioned in the NCRT. We'll read these and then our class is done. Okay. Fizi's option, it arises because of van der Waals forces. Chemi's option arises because it is chemical bond formation. Fizi's option, it is not specific in nature. What does it mean? It means that you can take any solid like charcoal, yeah, and you can adsorb any gas on it. Okay, it can adsorb H2 gas, it can adsorb water as well, it can adsorb N2 gas. Charcoal can adsorb anything using Fizi's option. It's not specific to a certain thing. But Chemi's option, do you realize you need a certain solid and a certain liquid, or a certain solid and a certain gas, so that they can make a chemical reaction happen between them? Yeah. If Chemi's option was not specific, then on this pen there would be lots of gaseous molecules always attacking. That wouldn't be a good idea, isn't it? So this is like a chemical reaction happening on the surface. It is very specific. You need certain specific items to do this particular reaction. Fizi's option can happen anywhere, depends just on the kind of solid that you have. It is reversible in nature, as I told you, easy to break off. This guy is irreversible in nature, as I told you, very hard, almost impossible to break off. Depends on the nature of the gas, more easily liquefied gases are adsorbed readily. Do you understand this? Sorry. What do we mean by easily liquefiable gases? Let's try to understand this particular term. Okay. What do we mean by easily liquefiable gases? My dear friends, gases that can become liquids easily, they already have good forces of attraction between them. Yes. Agar ek gaseous system hai, usme achhi interaction hai pehle se hi, aram se liquid ban jayega. Yeah. Gases that attract each other already, they will become liquids very easily. So those forces of attractions can work with a solid as well. Easy adsorption. So gases that are liquefiable easily show better adsorption. And let me remind you of one concept from van der Waals theory of gases. P plus An square by V square into V minus NB is equal to NRT. Do you remember this equation? Van der Waals gas equation. Over here, do you remember that if A is higher, then the gas is easily liquefiable? Easily liquefiable. Remember, this A basically tells you about the forces of attraction between the gas. More forces of attraction between the gas, more forces of attraction will be there with the solid, and it will be easier for the gas to be adsorbed. More is the A value for a van der Waals gas, easier is its adsorption. Please remember this fact. This can be asked directly in your examinations. Okay, fine. On the other hand, Chemi's option, it also depends on the nature of the gas. Gases which can react with adsorbent show Chemi's option. Yeah. So both of the cases depend on the nature of the gas. Over here, gas needs to be easily liquefiable. Over here, the gas needs to actually react with the solid. And this depends on case to case basis. We'll study more examples of Chemi's option in catalysis very soon. Not the channel catalysis, the subtopic of this chapter, catalysis. Sorry. One more thing, enthalpy of adsorption is low in this case. Again, this is exothermic. They're just giving the magnitude. So in Fizi's option, only 20 to 40 kilojoules per mole is released. In Chemi's option, 80 to 240 kilojoules per mole of energy is released. These points are mentioned in the NCERT. You anyway have to read it after the class. Chalo. Ye ho gaya. Done. Moving forward. Low temperature is favorable for the adsorption. It decreases with increase of temperature because of Le-Chatelier's principle. But over here the kinetics matter. High temperature is favorable for adsorption. It increases with the increase of temperature because you need activation energy. This is more like an equilibrium. This is more like a kinetic process. That is why the difference in temperature. Once you reach equilibrium in chemisorption, yeah, then you can reduce the temperature. Fine. So the thing is, initially for chemisorption, you need a higher temperature. No appreciable activation energy is needed. Apne aap ho jata. Room temperature has enough activation energy for it. Over here, high activation energy is sometimes needed. Physisorption depends on surface area. This also depends on surface area. That is why we study it in surface phenomena. More surface, more adsorption. This one results into multi-molecular layers on adsorbent surface under high pressure. This one results only in a unimolecular layer. I'll just show you an image and you'll understand what it is trying to say. I'll just draw it over here. Yahan pe main draw kar deta hun. So the thing is, if you have a solid surface, these gaseous molecules accumulated on top of it, more molecules can be accumulated like this. Okay, if you have high pressure conditions, all these gaseous molecules can be adsorbed on the surface of the solid like this. Multi-molecular layer. Over here in chemisorption, since it is a chemical reaction and very specific bonds are getting formed, okay, it's not just general force of attraction. It's not like some stage show is going on, you go there and like, okay, fine. No, this is a very specific force of attraction. Yeah, you're going there to give a job interview and only specific people will be selected. Something like that. So over here, only a unimolecular layer is formed. Multimolecular layer is not formed in chemisorption because it's more specific. It's a chemical reaction. This is just a chilled out process of two things attracting each other for a short span of time. Okay. Badiya. Mauj ho gayi. Purna is asking about critical temperature. Think about it. Critical temperature is what temperature beyond which the gas cannot be liquefied. So if you have a very high critical temperature, then think what will happen. Yeah. Think about it. If it's easy to liquefy a gas, it gets adsorbed better. Think about the relationship with critical temperature yourself. Chalo ji. People who are asking about the Telegram link, just go to the description box down below. It should be there. Okay, this is done. People, we're done with today's class. Aaj ki class khatam. Okay, so what did we learn today? Let me quickly summarize it for all of you. Before I summarize, I have a minion who wants to say something. Please do this because, yeah. So what did we do today? We understood what is adsorption. We saw the examples of adsorption. We just thought about them. Yeah. After that, we saw the definition of adsorption and we realized what is the reason behind adsorption. Then we understood the energetics of the adsorption. It is an exothermic process which is always coupled with the decrease in entropy of the system. So that equation can reach equilibrium, and then at equilibrium, if you reduce the temperature, the process is more favored. That is what we understood. Then we understood that it's not that simple. Adsorption can happen in two different ways. One can be physisorption, which is based on van der Waals forces, and one can be chemisorption, which is based on actual chemical bonds. So this acts like a chemical reaction. Physisorption is just van der Waals forces of attraction, and we saw the exact differences between both of those processes. Fine. Now, before I let you leave, there is an interesting experiment that I want to tell you about. Okay. What happens is, and this is an experiment that's written in the NCERT as well. So I would tell you that your homework for today's class is to read the NCERT. For sure, you have to read at least the first 4 or 5 pages of NCERT of this chapter. Okay. So read the NCERT and pretty much. Okay, so homework is to read the NCERT. Just let me tell you before you guys leave, next class is tomorrow at 8:30 p.m. Okay. So next class of surface chemistry tomorrow at 8:30 p.m. ye 6 lag raha hai, main 8 acche se banata hu. Tomorrow at 8:30 p.m. So the experiment that I was telling you about is, you take a chalk, ओके आपको क्या लेना है, यू टेक अ चॉक, चॉक दैट यू राइट ऑन योर ब्लैक बोर्ड विद, एंड यू पुट इट इन अ बॉक्स, या यू पुट इट इन अ बॉक्स, यू पुट इट इन अ कंटेनर विच हैज अ लॉट ऑफ इंक, इंक इन वॉटर. Okay, what is ink? Ink is basically color dissolved in water, right? So once you dissolve the chalk inside this particular water, what will happen is the surface of the chalk will hold the ink molecules. The surface of the chalk will hold ink molecules. So outside the chalk will become colored, but inside the chalk will not have color. Okay, so this particular chalk, okay, it absorbs the ink and at the same time it also absorbs water. And if you're dyslexic, then these two words are very difficult to read. English. Yeah, so the ink gets absorbed only on the surface, but inside the chalk all the water goes there. Okay, so pretty much. One more example, a very interesting example that I just thought of. People, do you know about candle filters? Yeah. Have you seen those water filters which have candles in them? I mean, the regular filters that we use these days, they also have a candle in it. Okay. So what happens is the impure water goes to the candle. On the candle, the impurities get absorbed. The water goes inside and comes down in your water filter. Yeah. Have you seen that? इन फिल्टर्स तो कैंडल फिल्टर में ऐसा एक कैंडल सा रहता है ओके एंड दिस इज द आउटलेट ऑफ वॉटर फाइन सो दिस पार्ट इज सेपरेटेड दिस पार्ट इज सेपरेटेड सो यू पुट अ लॉट ऑफ इम्प्योर वॉटर ओवर हेयर यू पुट अ लॉट ऑफ इम्प्योर वॉटर ओवर हेयर इम्प्योर वॉटर फाइन एंड दैट इम्प्योर वॉटर वॉट इट डज इज द इम्प्योरिटीज जस्ट स्टिक टू द सर्फेस Okay, the impurities just stick to the surface of the candle. The rest of the water goes inside the candle and then comes out of the outlet. Over here, you get your pure water. So the impurities get absorbed onto the surface of this candle. Yeah, fine. So lots of different names for this particular process. In the chalk as well, the same thing is happening. The ink gets absorbed on the surface. Inside, water goes, but the chalk doesn't get colored from the inside. So if you have to make colored chalk, you have to make it from scratch. Yeah, you have to color every molecule of chalk and then combine it in that cylindrical form. Fine. Chalo. Mandar Joshi, my lectures for 11th and 12th class are on this channel itself. You can check the playlists out. Fine. So people, that's it for today's class. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, share and subscribe to this channel. And in case you need more resources, they are on our channel already. Let me just show you two things that you can do on our channel. So what you can do is open the homepage of our channel, which looks like this. And you go to the playlist section. All the chapters that we've done till now, all the revision classes, all the question solving classes, the playlists of them are right here. Okay. स्ट्रैटेजी सेशंस है केमिकल बॉन्डिंग फुल क्लासेस कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड फुल क्लासेस थर्मो फुल क्लास हाइड्रोजन फुल क्लासेस या एवरीथिंग इज हियर फाइन एंटी अभ्यास मॉक टेस्ट सॉल्विंग इज हियर इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रिवाइज चैप्टर्स क्विकली लेट्स रेविट प्ले लिस्ट इज देयर फॉर यू इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सॉल्व डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर एवरी चैप्टर आर्ट ऑफ डिडक्शन प्ले लिस्ट इज देयर फॉर यू ओके ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ थिंग्स आर ओवर हियर एंड इन केस you want to join Vedantu as a long-term dedicated student in our long courses or crash courses, all you need to do is go down to the description box of today's class. Okay? Just niche jana description box mein and over here you've got it. Okay? So you've got the links to the crash courses, crash course for JEE 2021. All right? And you can enroll in it very easy. For NEET as well, we've got a crash course. Live daily classes. Lots of questions, lots of study material will be given to you. Tests will be there. You will automatically be a part of the test series. Tests every Sunday, rank tests. You know all the advantages that are there. Yeah. And you can join a longer term course for 1 year if you're preparing for 2022. Those will be available here. Chalo ji. Information dissipation done. You can choose whatever you want to enroll in. So people, once again, thank you so much for joining. I hope you enjoyed this very first class of surface chemistry. If you did, please make sure you hit that like button. And tomorrow we'll meet again at 8:30 to discuss the second part of this particular chapter. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye. I'm gonna see you soon.